Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard training. This is a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. Today, we'll cover one of the most fundamental statistics used in the laboratory, the standard deviation. Let's begin with the definition. The standard deviation quantifies how close numerical values are in relation to each other. This is the formula for calculating the standard deviation. Let's pick it apart so that you can better understand it. Sigma indicates a sum. X sub n represents each value in the data set. Bar x represents the mean or average of the QC values. So this portion of the formula is the sum of the squares of the differences between individual QC values and the mean. Let's simplify that language just a little bit. We'll be subtracting the mean from each value in the data set. Then we'll square those values and add them all together. Finally, we'll divide by the number of values in the data set minus 1. Now that you understand how the formula works, let's practice by plugging some values into it. We'll begin by calculating the mean. The mean is simply the sum of the values in the data set divided by the number of values in the data set. I encourage you to take a look at our video for calculating the mean if you'd like additional information. In our example, we'll use a mean of 4.1. Again, here's our formula for calculating the standard deviation. Let's move it down to the corner just in case we need it. Here are the values in our data set, the mean, and our formula. Let's begin by entering all of the values into our formula. Now we'll take a moment to pick things apart so that you can get a better understanding of what's going on. The number to the left of the minus sign is a value from our data set. The number to the right of the minus sign is our mean. This pattern repeats for all of the values in the data set. The divisor is the number of data points minus 1. In the next step, the subtraction occurs. The values are squared and added. The division occurs and the square root is taken. The standard deviation is 0.082, or 1/10 when rounded. Now let's do a little practice. The next segment of the video shows a data set that you can use to practice calculating the standard deviation. Pause the video when the data set appears. This will give you a chance to grab a pen, paper, or a calculator. Then calculate the standard deviation and restart the video. I'll provide the correct answer and how I got it. Here's our data set and our mean. Remember that our formula is down in the corner. Go ahead and pause the video now. The standard deviation is 0.075, or 0.08 when rounded. Here's how I got that figure. First, I entered all the values into the formula. Then I completed the subtraction for each of the terms. The values were then squared and added. The division occurs and the square root is taken. The standard deviation is 0.075, or 0.08 when rounded. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. Following videos in this series will cover standard deviation index, coefficient of variation, and coefficient of variation ratio.